Okay, well, this is the example that I just gave, and I would like to just continue showing how when you make a decision at each point in the KD tree of whether to go left or right, what you're actually doing is partitioning the space that you have. So when I inserted the 3-7, what that did right here was to partition the space between things less than or equal to 3 and greater than 3. And the way I'm going to indicate this in my picture is to find my x equals 3, and I partition my whole space, right? So I've got everything less than or equal to 3 and everything, well, just less than 3 and everything greater than 3. My 8-1, that's in the right-hand side, so that's over here, and then I'll be using this to partition the space into less than or equal to y equals 1, greater than or equal to y equals 1. So let me draw that line right here. Here's my x1 point right here. So there's the partitioning that I have now caused by that new node that's just inserted. The 6-6, that'll be on the right-hand side of the 3 line, and then it'll be on the top side of the 1 line. So the 6-6 is going to be, well, it's located right here, and it's going to be a partition. We could see it's red, so it's a partition of the x space that's greater than 1. So let me draw that slice right there. So I've got 6-6 right here. Okay. My 2-6, the 2 is less than 3, so that is on the left-hand side of that space. So here's my 2-6 right here. Right, there's my point. And this does a partition in my y space between less than 6, greater than 6. So there's that partition. Whoops, it's got to be blue, doesn't it? There's that partition right there. And slice right there. Okay, my 1-7. 1 is less than 3. 7 is greater than 6. So that means I'll be dividing up my available x space less than 3 into things that is less than or equal to 1. So here's that x space right here. Oops, that's kind of ugly looking, but there it is right there. Okay, and then the 8-6. 8 is going to be on the side greater than 3, so it'll be in here somewhere. And then the 6 is greater than 1, so it's in this area right here. And then the 8 is greater than the 6 right here, so it'll be over in this area right here, okay? So we can see this is my 8-6 point right here, and I'll be so it's in that area, right, caused by the partitioning going down, and then that 8-6 new node will cause a partition in the y dimension of between 6, less than 6, greater than 6. So there's that partition right there. Okay, and then last we have the 5-9. 5 is greater than 3. 9 is greater than 1. 5 is less than 6. So that means that here's my 5-9 right here, my 5-9 point. 5 is greater than 3, so it's on this side. 5 is greater than 3. 9 is greater than 1, so it's in here. Can you see that? It's in here. 5 is less than 6, so I'm now in this area. And in fact, at this point, I think I'm going to just draw sort of the area that I am at this point right here. Okay, so I've got my 5 is less than 6 right there. And so that's where my 5-9 point is. It's somewhere in this area. And then when I insert that new point, it's going to cause a partition of the remain of the y dimension inside that area right here. Right there. Okay. So that's the idea of how the KD tree that I constructed here partitions up the area. So if I have this area right here, a point in that area is going to be in the less than 3, less than x equals 3, and the less than y equals 6 domain.